Hi and welcome to the 2 Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff and today we're going to talk about how to use an oscilloscope in normal trigger mode to capture an infrequent signal. So I have channel 1 hooked up to my function generator and I have it producing a 1 hertz pulse. So you may see that flashing on the screen about once per second. Now why is that signal not right in the center of the screen where I expect my scope to be triggering? It's happening this way because I'm in auto trigger mode instead of normal trigger mode. So let's see what this looks like if I switch the scope to normal mode. Just a quick side note, if you don't know what I mean when I talk about triggering, check out this video from a couple episodes ago. It talks about and explains triggering on your oscilloscope. So to set your scope to normal acquisition mode, hit the mode coupling button and then set your mode to normal. And once your scope is set to normal, you'll see the signal dead center on the screen. What's the difference between auto mode and normal mode? So essentially in auto mode, the oscilloscope's trigger circuitry is waiting for a valid trigger. If after a certain amount of time it doesn't see a valid trigger, it's just gonna go ahead and acquire data and display it anyway. So the time that it waits is gonna be different from scope to scope, but usually it's dependent on the amount of time you have on screen, so that time per division setting. So normal mode is fundamentally different in that there's no timeout period, it's simply gonna wait as long as it has to get a valid trigger. And that's why when I switch the scope to normal trigger mode, I'm getting a regular trigger once per second, and I'm not acquiring or displaying any other data except for around that valid trigger. Now I said that the timeout in auto mode is dependent on the time on screen, so let's go ahead and show that. If I go into auto mode, I can see that my screen is flickering again, but if I zoom out to a much slower time per division, I'm gonna start getting a stable trigger. That's because the timeout in auto trigger mode is now longer than it was before because I have a longer time per division on screen. So now that once per second signal is gonna be triggering consistently. Now why would I even have auto mode? If auto and normal triggering mode look the same under these settings and when I was zoomed in, normal triggering worked better. Auto mode is nice because you can still see some signal displayed on the screen and go in and set up your scope appropriately for the signals that you just hooked up to. Thank you so much for watching this week's 2 Minute Guru. We're gonna have new videos every Tuesday on this channel, so make sure you hit the subscribe button if you wanna stay up to date to those, or even if you don't, hit the subscribe button anyway. Also, go like our Facebook page. I'm on Twitter, so you can also give me suggestions that way instead of putting them in the comments. @Keysight_Daniel, the link's below. And I will see you next week. Thank you so much for watching.